Today in this video, we are going to look at the concept of class and object. But before discussing about class and object, we will look at some important points about object-oriented programming language in C++. So these are, first is data encapsulation, data abstraction, inheritance and polymorphism. So we'll start with data encapsulation, which is a mechanism by which we can manipulate or encapsulate data members and member function together into a single unit, and also to keep them safe from external interference. Now this point is mainly used by class and object, and we'll talk about it later. Then we'll move on to data abstraction. It refers to the practice of representing essential features without the inclusion of background details. Then we have inheritance. It is a mechanism or technique by which we can derive a new class from an existing class. It only satisfies the principle of reusability in C++. Then the last point is polymorphism. It refers to many forms, and by this we can use same names for operators or functions used at different occasions that differ on the type of arguments passed. By this we only mean that we have two techniques, that are operator overloading and function overloading, that follow the principle of polymorphism. Then we move on to the main topic, that is class and object. Class is a user defined data type that encapsulates data and associated functions together within a single unit. Or you can say that classes are user defined data types that behave like an inbuilt type of programming language. So as you can see that class uses the principle of data encapsulation. Then we have object. An object is an instance of class, or an object is a variable of class, or an object is a runtime entity defined by class that contains codes to manipulate the data. I know that you will be a bit confused by these definitions, so please consider this. Suppose there is a house. The house has some rooms with doors, and we have the keys to unlock the house. Then house is the class, the rooms are its data members, the doors are the member functions, and the keys are the class objects. I hope that you will get the relationship between the class and object by this small example of mine. But if you didn't, then please stick to the end of the video, where we will be discussing the class and object with the help of an example. So now we will look at the syntax to define a class. The syntax to define a class is as follows. Class, class name, then we have the private access specifier, then its data members and member functions, public data member, member functions, and protected data members and member functions. Now here we should note that by default the members of a class are private. That is, if we do not mention the access specifier of a member, then it is taken as private by the compiler. And please remember to terminate or use this semicolon after the closing parenthesis of the class. Now we take a look at the access specifiers. These are mainly used to specify the access to a data member of the class. These are private, public and protected. So first access specifier is private. It means that if a data member has a private access specifier, then that data member can only be accessed by the member functions of the class and not the class object. Then we have the public access specifier. It means that data members that have public as their access specifier, then these data members can be accessed by the member functions as well as the object of the class. The third type of access specifier is protected access specifier, which means that if the data members have protected access specifier, then they can only be accessed by member functions of the class and not the class object. By looking at the definitions of these three, you will be wondering that what is the main difference between private and protected access specifiers, as they both have the same definition. The main difference is private data members can't be inherited in the child class or derived class, but the protected members can be inherited. And in this table, I have shown the accessibility of data members of a class by using a member function and by using the class object. So as stated earlier, the private data members can be accessed with the help of member functions but not with the help of class object, and the public data members can be accessed with the help of member functions as well as with the help of class objects, while the protected data members can only be accessed with the help of member functions but not with the help of class object. So now we're going to look at a simple example. So here is that example. In this, I have used a class XYZ that which has a data member A, data member B and data member C. But you can see here that A is a private data member, B is a protected data member and C is a public data member. As stated earlier, since the access specifier of A is not mentioned, that's why the compiler will consider it as private. Now we'll move on to the main program. Here object 1 is the object of class XYZ and this statement is error because A is a private member and we cannot access it directly with the help of the object of the class. The second statement is also an error because B is a protected data member and we cannot access it with the help of the object of class. But this statement is not error because C is a public data member and we can access it with the help of the object of the class. Now here you will be noticing these dots. The dot operator is used to access the members of a class and also the member functions. So that is how we have to write or we can access the data members with the help of the object of the class, and also we can access the member functions of the class, which we'll be seeing in the next example.
Bolo.
So now let us see another example. So in this example, I have taken a class XYZX. The members are M, N and O. M is the private data member, N is protected data member and O is the public data member. Then we have two functions that are get and show. Get is used to get the values of M, N and O and show is to display the values. Then we move on to the main program. Here obj is the object of class XYZX. So in this line, as you can see that the object obj of the class, it accesses the get function and the function gets the values of M, N and O. And in this line, obj accesses the show function, which displays the values of M, N, and O. And this is the output of this program. As you can see in this program, there is no error because we are using the actual member functions of the class to access the private and protected members, which are M and N. But in the previous example, we were directly accessing these private and protected members with the help of objects, and that's why they were giving an error. So this is how you can access the private and protected members with the help of the member functions of the class.